magnets and electronic devices don't match well. Oh well, that's what I learned when I was younger, way before I even became an IT guy, let alone an ex-IT guy. But how much effect do magnets have on modern electronics? Do you have to fear data loss if there's a magnet next to your SD card? Let's find out! It's the The idea for this video came to me when a company reached out to me to test their magnetic USB cables. No, this is not one of theirs. They had so many demands in order to send me a $20 cable that I basically told them no. So I went to find a similar one on AliExpress, which set me back a little over 2 euros. The cable jacket is magnetic, so it will stay rolled up and won't get all tangled up. That's all there is to it. Anyway, I didn't really like the idea of a magnet close to any of my devices. But that fear might just be very much ungrounded with today's hardware. To test this, I will scrub this cable over an SD card, my Manuette diskette and a USB stick. If that doesn't do any harm, I also have this neodymium magnet taken from an old hard drive. This thing is so strong I haven't even been able to release it from its container. First, I will copy some files from this SD card. This card contains some footage from earlier videos. Let's put them in a new subfolder. Right, now I have the original files, let's check their MD5 sums. MD5 is a hashing method that can be used to check a file's integrity. MD5 sums are often supplied with large downloads, so the receiver can check if the files are still intact. Change one bit of a file and the MD5 hash changes as well. So, as long as the MD5 sum of a file stays the same, we can be pretty sure that a file is completely intact. Right, now I have a list of the MD5 sums of all files in my folder. Let's take the card out and rub it against this magnetic USB cable. Running Dolphin as root can be dangerous! Yeah, I know. You usually shouldn't do this, but I forgot the user password for this install. Why don't you just reset the password then? Well, because I'm, you know, lazy. Anyway, the file's copied without issues. Let's get the MD5 sums again. I'll compare them with a diff command. No output, which means they are the same. But let's put them side by side so you can see for yourself. A little wider. You see, no difference, so the magnetic cable doesn't seem to do any harm to the SD card. What about the strong neodymium magnet? Give it a good rub! Let's copy the files again in yet another folder. Get the sums again. The same, no difference! I really was not expecting this. So it seems that SD cards are completely safe from magnets. While I was editing this video, I wondered why I didn't just use MD5 sums check function instead of the diff command. That way I wouldn't have to save the sums each time. Anyway, the result is the same. Let's move on to the Manuette diskette from my previous video. Being magnetic or storage, we should see some other results for sure. Let's just copy the zip files. But to be honest, I have no idea how to select just the zip files from a graphical interface. So let's copy them from our console. Alright, get the sums. Cool, take it out and give it a cable treatment. Copy the files again. No issues here. Get the sums and compare. No problems at all. I was not expecting that. so it appears these cables are even safe to use around magnetic storage. Alright, let's kill it with a neodymium magnet. Look, it sticks! Okay, let's see if it still works. It has a lot of trouble reading the diskette. Just see if we can copy the zip files again. Lot of errors. And a lot of files are simply missing. Let's get the sums. Yeah, this was to be expected. Even the files that did get copied are gone. So I guess this demonstrates my fear of magnets near my hardware pretty well. So how would USB sticks do? I think it will be about the same as the SD card, but let's test that. I cleared this stick and copied the footage from the SD card onto it. Right, let's copy it back and see if the files are still intact before playing with magnets. That was way too fast. That must have come from file system cache. Let's unplug it and plug it back in to try again. That's more like it. Alright, get the sums. And as expected, they are still the same as the source files. Now the cable treatment. Copy the files again. Get the sums. Still fine. Alright, now the hard disk magnet. Copy. Get the sums. Still fine. Alright, so flash storage is fine. As a last test, I brought out an old phone of mine. Let's see if I notice anything with that. Well, the cable doesn't seem to have any effect on it. Neither does the hard disk magnet. Wi-Fi keeps working as well, and I can still open my own website on it. When it touches the screen, it seems to register some false touches, but that's about it. So I think we can assume that magnets don't do a lot of harm on modern hardware. By the way, that cable seems to do as advertised, but I haven't tested it thoroughly. I was able to charge my phone and copy files from it, and even charging my MacBook seems to work, but it was already fully charged, so I can't say for sure. It only supports USB 2.0, which also means I couldn't use it to connect a monitor. There's a link in the description if you'd like to check it out. Anyway, that's all I have for you today. I hope you liked this video. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.